occupation is I own Heather Moreno Wellness Services. I am also a licensed CPA.
You're already the mayor, but why do you want to continue this line of work for the city of Atascadero?
I love this city and I love the work that we've been doing, and I want to continue to build a strong and diverse local economy. I want to continue kind of sustaining us in this spirit of fiscal stewardship and moving forward. And there are a lot of great things happening here, and I want to help finish those out.
Great. And what are some of the biggest issues right now that you think are kind of up against for the city, and maybe things that you've been working on too in your term?
Sure. So I think the most important thing that we need to do, one of the most important things, is we really need to build a balanced economy. And what I mean by that is our number of head of household, good paying jobs need to be on par with our housing supply. And right now we have an imbalance. And what that creates is sort of a bedroom community. And so we need to have more people here during the day, which then feeds into our restaurant retail sector. So the more businesses you have, the more restaurant retail, then that breeds more business, and that continues on each other. So some of the things I've done in that vein is I pulled together a group to look at co-working, and we ended up opening the first co-working space here in the North County. Last year, I convened investors and businesses, and we looked at reimagining Del Rio, because we know that retail is changing, and so that's not going to be Walmart and a bunch of shopping. What might that look like? And so coming up next week, we're going to be looking at changing that specific plan for 230,000 square feet of business park space, so light tech or tech, light manufacturing, those good paying jobs that we want here in Atascadero. So we need to be doing more of that. I think in order to be competitive, not just in Atascadero, but countywide, we really need to look at investing in broadband. We don't rate well as a county. And so I will be advocating for using some of our SB 1090 funds, working regionally, particularly North County. How can we look for grant funding, and how can we look at bringing broadband here to Atascadero?
Great. Moving on here to the next question too, dealing with homelessness. I know that that's something when I've interviewed just the other candidates as well, and I think community members might say similar things. It seems to be something that continues to be, I don't want to say it's, maybe it is a major issue. Would you consider it a major issue in your community with the homeless population? What are your plans to kind of mitigate that?
So I think it's an issue in California. It's not just Atascadero, just San Luis. It's throughout the state, and I know other places in the nation as well. So when we talk about homeless, we need to realize that they're not a homogeneous population. We have the homeless who have fallen on hard times, and they're looking for services. They want to get back on their feet. And Atascadero, we have Echo, 60-bed shelter. Just in my time on mayor, we worked with them, increased that to 60 beds. They're now 24/7 service. So they do an excellent job at a very low cost of helping people who want to get back on their feet and get into housing do that. And we have a tremendously generous community that helps out with that. We also have Transitions Food and Shelter, which operates the medically fragile homeless program and the warming center here in Atascadero. So we do a lot in Atascadero for the unsheltered population. There's also part of that population, the transient population, that maybe they're experiencing addiction, maybe mental health challenges, some who simply choose that lifestyle. We find it hard to believe, but that does happen. Currently, we have someone from the community action team that is embedded with police, so we're able to offer those social services, mental health type services to unsheltered individuals. Some, a very small handful, take us up on that, and that's great. We've had some success. By far, most do not, and it's unfortunate. If we can find the funding, I would love to increase that, because I think the more touches we get, the more you increase trust with those individuals, and then the more likely they are to take services. But that's the challenge we have. But I would say in Atascadero, we do a great job. I've helped to advocate for HEAP funds and others that both ECHO and TFS have been beneficiaries of, also helping to be a part of the conversation with ECHO and Paso, and how do we look at this again more regionally in the North County? And Paso is really stepping up, and I love what's going to be happening there with ECHO involved.
Great. How do you plan to continue to support small businesses that have all really been impacted by the pandemic. I think this is a new dialogue this year with elections, is how do you help these businesses rebound when they've been faced with so much hardship? And even looking ahead to the next year, what does that mean for your community?
Yeah, I think short term, that's probably the most critical thing that any community is looking at right now. And so with COVID from the get-go, the minute the shelter at home hit, we called every single business. Anyone that had a business license with Atascadero, we were calling them, letting them know about resources, government funding. We've been in regular contact. One of the things we recently did is when things kind of shut back down here in California, we said, okay, you know, as any other community did, how do we operate outside? And so we were the only city in the county that reduced our permit fees to zero so we could help businesses do that safely and not further tax them. I think it's going to be, we're going to need to be flexible. We're going to need to be in constant communication. And how do we help in the way that we can by removing barriers? And the great thing about Atascadero is we're always scrappy and we're creative. We're always looking for grant funding. We're always figuring out how to make things work. So I think we're well suited to help businesses do that.
Great. And this is another topic that's come up, and I've actually covered it before, but the roads in Atascadero, I know that there has been funding for that. And it is an interesting dynamic and approach, in that not every road is maintained by the city or even the county. Sometimes it's up to the citizen. So I'm just curious if there's any sort of initiative, or if you have any comments on that to improve them, or what that looks like, the trajectory to improve local roads.
So we have about 170 miles of roadway in Atascadero.
Pretty a lot.
It is. It is. 140 of those are city maintained. And in 2014, the voters passed Measure F14, and that is a half-cent sales tax that we said we will put specifically to roads. And we've done that. Since that passed, we've done, when I've looked at it, it's been over 20 miles of neighborhood local roads. And folks are really seeing that. The way we decide those roads is very strategic. There is a program, an engineering program, and it shows that you want to catch the road right before it falls into the next category, because it's going to be exponentially more expensive to fix it. So sometimes citizens might look and say, well, why are you working on this road that looks like it's in okay condition, and then this one that's in pretty bad condition? Why aren't you doing that one first? And it comes down to, again, that cost benefit. If we've got to keep this one from falling into that next category, and this one has another 18 months of life on it, we've got to eke that out as much as we can. If there are potholes, things like that, report those potholes, we get those repaired, but we try to be as smart with every single dollar that we have.
Great. And my last question too, what makes you the better choice compared to other candidates to continue being the mayor of Atascadero?
It really comes down to leadership experience and understanding budgets, understanding how government works. It's also, I think, very important to have someone who knows how to collaborate and build consensus. We have a very diverse council. We don't always agree on everything. And some people will say a good mayor or a good council member knows how to count to three, right? You need 3 out of 5 votes. I think the better mayors are able to count to 5. And how often can you build that consensus and come together and not just try to push things through based upon kind of who has a majority? So I think that's very important. I think it's important to have been involved in budgeting process. We had 20 meetings this last 2 years on the budget, the financial statements, the financial condition. And I think it's important that any candidate has been a part of that conversation and understanding how things work. And I haven't seen that with my opponents. They're both involved in the community and wonderful individuals. I just haven't seen that involvement that tells me they have the leadership experience to really hit the ground running day one. And that's what Atascadero needs.
Is there anything else you want to add that I didn't ask you?
I just like to say that I think one of the most important things we do at the city is listen to the public. And it's important to have that engagement. We are making these decisions together. It's not 5 of us, nor is it me as a mayor saying this is how things work. That's not how it goes. And so in the last 2 years, I actually implemented a public outreach initiative. And in combination with the chamber, we took the city into the neighborhoods. It was called Talk on the Block. And we did 8 of those in the last year and a half. And it was really about having conversations with folks. We talked about things like vaping and fire safety, crosswalks, the downtown. I mean, anything that was on their mind. So we were able to answer questions, often get some issues taken care of within 24 hours that we didn't even know were issues, and they didn't even know how to go about reporting them. So it was really a great experience, both for the city and from my perspective, to learn more from our residents, and for them to really feel like we were there talking to them.